night.
Good evening, everybody.
Oh, that was pretty good. I said, good evening, everybody. All right. Welcome back to the movement. Monday nights, where we come together every Monday night right here in Huntington, West Virginia at 1400 Norway Avenue. We're glad for everybody tuning in. Turn around and wave to everybody tuning in. A lot of your families tune in. I never knew that. They're always looking like, can you turn the camera? Like, no, probably can't. Really excited about today. You guys know what today is. Observation of Juneteenth. Does anybody know about Juneteenth? Yeah. We're going to talk about it. We're going to talk about freedom tonight. We're going to talk about Juneteenth. I think every Christian needs them some Juneteenth. We're going to get into that and dig in about what Juneteenth really is and what happened. I think there's a lot of misconception about it. I think it is for us too, though. So we're going to talk about the relation from us Christians to the same thing. You guys ready for a good time tonight? No? Yeah. All right, then. I'm ready. Talking about freedom, man. Does anybody want to be free? Yeah. Anybody want to be free? Yeah. Is anybody already free? Yeah. I don't know. I relapsed. You didn't relapse. You just took a break. Right? Some of you ain't free yet. We need to get you free. We're going to talk about that tonight. True freedom. Not abstaining. Not, you know, I didn't use for 7 months. I'm talking about true freedom. True freedom will bring something else. True freedom will have you never want to go back. Amen? Amen. All right. You guys ready? All right, before we get started tonight, we want to make sure that we're part of everybody's spiritual journey and spiritual walk. We offer water baptism, which I believe is a huge part of your journey. It's a commandment by Jesus. If you're saved, it's probably the very next thing you probably should do is to be water baptized. That we take it so serious, we call it sealing the deal. And yeah, here you can get the shirts now. Wayne had one to seal the deal. So we believe that it is a real outward expression of an inward change and calling that's happened on your life. I think, and I believe it's a real commitment, you telling the world, I'm serious about my daddy's business. No different than you say, I'm going to be in recovery. If you are, it will really look like it. You won't have to tell me. You're not around me for about 5 minutes. You'll know I know Jesus, God, and I'm in recovery, right? That I mean it. Anybody that talks to me within 5 minutes, they know that. And so do they know? Your life should show this. It should be very well seen. And water baptism says that. I believe many people have a spiritual encounter at water baptism. I know I had my encounter with God, and I've seen many people have an encounter right here. It's definitely a commitment for you and a decision to walk this thing out. If you say you're going to be about it, probably should be about it, right? We say on the street, right? Don't talk about it. Why can't we do that on this side? Why is it we're in recovery and it can't be the same thing? Why is it I'm walking with God and it can't be the same thing? We got to be a bunch of fake and frauds and all them hypocrites at the church. I think we all are a hypocrite. There's room for one more, right? I'm not honest all the time. I'm not perfect either. I'm not going to stand up here and act like I am. Anybody that does is kidding you. But I think it's time that you're real. Right? I think it's time that we all are. I think there was about 50 people at their hand up came to God last week at some way or another. And if you've not been water baptized, it's probably your time. It's not a burden on you. That's not an obligation. Don't take it that way. But if you're serious, this should happen for you. Right? The only requirement for water baptism is you believe Jesus died for you and you're forgiven. You know that he's sitting at the right hand with our Father. He is still alive. Right? That's the only requirement, that you're saved and you believe you're forgiven. Right? We have clothes. We have towels. The only thing required is your willing heart. Amen? All right. So does anybody here tonight believe there is a God? He is up there. Raise your hand if you know there's a God. Yeah. All right. Yeah. All right. If you don't think so yet, just keep watching. If you woke up today, you probably should see him. If you're part of that group and you said you believe God's real, you believe Jesus died for you and you're forgiven. Yeah. You know that? All right. Sorry. If you're part of that group and you're ready to take this next step, is anybody ready to be water baptized tonight? Ready to change your life? Yeah. One right there. Come on, sister. Get up. Just get up out of your seat. Come on over here with me, right over here to this wall. You ready? Okay, come on. I said get up out of your seat, and he stood up. All right, let's go, bro. Okay. All right, if you guys would stand to your feet, let's open up with praise and worship with the movement team.
Your faithfulness to me. setting, same I will praise your name. Great is your faithfulness to me.
Jesus, you brought heaven down.
Good evening, everybody. Give it up one more time for the Movement Praise and Worship Team. Juneteenth. June the 19th. I didn't even know what it was until a couple years ago. Has anybody ever heard of Juneteenth? I know you better. All five of you. Great. Yeah. Six, okay. I said five. He said, back here. Don't forget me. Wasn't saying that when I said, who knows God? Back here. I don't know. Maybe I do. I don't know. They say Abraham Lincoln freed the slaves. Anybody ever heard that? Kind of true. He did initiate some work that started. And the statistics numbers say that he really only probably freed 500,000 of 3.4 million. That there was a position in place that all states weren't compliant in coming into effect of what should have happened. So therefore, there were states, and especially Texas being there then, that even though a group of people had been set free, they were still slaves. For another 2.5 years. Now, some people would say they just didn't know. The news had not traveled, and so they still just lived whatever way. Kind of true. Not so much, though. The truth is, they were still being lied to and being oppressed. And so even though they were free, they lived under slavery for another 2.5 years. It was when a general, and I'll get his name right maybe here, I think it's General Gordon Granger, finally marches in there with 2,000 troops and tells them, that's it, these people are free. And so that's known as their Emancipation Freedom Day on June 19th, 1965, 1865, not 19, 1865. But it was 2 years prior to that, on like January 1st of 63, when Lincoln set this stuff in order. Can you imagine? I think about slavery and just horrific to me. I mean, just awful. And to think they were free, but still not living like they're free. Or in another position, to not know they're free, to be oppressed and still not be free, right? So it hit me today. I had a whole other message I was bringing. I was going to finish that other message. Then I had another one. No. I think some Christians need them some Juneteenth. Think of you and your very own life, of how free are you? Some of you would like to think you're free. The truth is, you're just on the loose. That's what they told me a couple times. I'm free. He said, no, he ain't. He just on the loose. Okay? They might have let him out of jail. He ain't free. Some of you would like to say you're free or think you're free, and you're not. The first area I'd like to speak about that being free piece is, if you have not, and this is not to proselytize, make anybody believe like I believe, or, but you know, if you're here, you're probably already headed in the right direction, but you need to hear this information. If you have never accepted Jesus having died for you to give you your forgiveness, you're not free. I don't care what connection you have with a higher power of God, because you're still going to face somebody one day, and it's God, and say, hey, let's handle that sin debt of mine. I knew that from a child for some reason. Man, it scared the lights out of me. I knew I had this barrier with me and God. Remember being little, they said, don't get in a cookie jar. First thing you do, get in a cookie jar. You do everything wrong they tell you don't do. The more rule they put on you, the more you want to break them. That's the truth. The Bible says that the law is the strength of sin, right? The more rules they put on you, the more you, oh, okay. I'll fight that thing, right? And so knowing that you have this issue, you have a lot of issue in your life. Can we call it issue for a minute? Sin, issue, it's this stuff. You got stuff in your life? I got stuff in my life today. Anybody got stuff? Have you been forgiven of it? Some of you have. Some of you may have not. If you have not, what you're saying in theory is this, whether you know it or not, you will face God one day. And what you're saying is, I'll let Stacy, 50 Cent, Stacy, used to be 50 Cent, Stacy be God. I'd like to stand before God one day and say, hey, let's settle it up. Let's me and you take a look at my life and settle up right now. How does that feel? What do you think that's going to look like? You think you say, oh, no problem, buddy. I forgive you. Go on. Without the shedding of blood, there is no forgiveness, remission of sin. You decide, yours or his. I knew mine was too costly. I didn't like the thought that I had to answer to God for all my stuff and what that was going to look like. Right? That's not to scare you, by the way. That's just the truth. You want to stand before God and say, hey, let's settle up? It's the truth. Right? And so when they finally told me, man, I had never heard it till my mid to late 20s. I didn't know Jesus died for me to forgive me. I'm like, oh my God, this is the truest thing I ever heard. Like, I was so excited because I knew I had that issue, right? So you've never gotten free if you've not done that piece because you're not forgiven. So you're still dealing with you and your stuff, right? It's all still you, right? And if you work this program and all the other book we talk about, the blue book, it says self can't fix self, right? Haven't we tried up until now? If I could have did it, I would have. That it takes God. And the only way I found to truly connect with God, not to say God won't show up if you don't know Jesus. I've seen him do it. Read the Old Testament. God showed up all the time. God shows up at AA all the time and people that still don't know Jesus, and he goes, and he'll breathe his grace on people that get clean and sober for some reason, don't know Jesus yet. Most of them do later on, but and just shows up. But if you want to truly know God, you have got to get this forgiveness piece out of the way. Right? Everybody get it? All right. So if you want to be free, first thing is you're going to have to be forgiven. If you've not done that piece, consider that. The next thing is, there's many of us, just like me, I received my forgiveness. The next 8 years of my life, as you guys well know, I say it all the time, the next 8 years of my life were the worst they had ever been. Because I was still living under oppression, just like the slaves in Texas. I didn't know I was free and didn't know how to live free, and I was still being oppressed. Mostly by my own thinking and being tricked by the devil and the lust of the world and the fallen world, right? And so because I was still living oppressed, I wasn't free either. I had to change my mind about the way I thought about things and viewed and seen things so I could live differently. Just like those people had to be told that they were free, I didn't know I was free. I was still a slave to sin in my mind, right? See, there's this place of, you can be a Christian and be destined for heaven, but be whack here. I've seen it a lot. Some of the best people I know are still like, bro, you're going to heaven, but you're whack, right? You may be saved, but you're whack, right? I was whack one time. And you'll have to change the way you view it and see it and think about it for you to be able to be free. And nobody had told me I was free. I'm battling with God going, I don't even know if this thing's real. Was I really saved or not saved? I come in and out of salvation about 1,003 times. Then I think I'm saved, I'm unsaved. Oh, I told a lie, I better repent again. Oh, God, forgive me. Please don't let me die before I say, forgive me. Right? That whole spiritual schizophrenia that we deal with of in and out, right? And me trying to be a spiritual robot at times and trying to be perfect like I ever could be and dealing with that and learning, I still wasn't free. I was bound to trying to behave, let my behavior look just right for you, right? As a whole nother bad place. But so I had to learn and change the way I thought about this. Think about those people, the same thing. They had to be told they were free, and someone show up and go, hey, you're free. I'm telling you tonight, if you believe Jesus died for you, you're free. You're no longer a slave to sin, but you are a slave to something else, and it should be him, because if it's not him, you'll put yourself back in bondage. You don't believe me? Give me that first scripture. The first one. It says it's for freedom that Christ set us free. You believe that? He did it for freedom, right? It says, therefore, keep standing firm and do not be subject again to take on the yoke of slavery. It was for freedom that he set us free. Therefore, stand firm, lest you again take on the bondage or yoke of slavery, right? Do you know that if you don't stand firm in your freedom, you'll be right back a slave again? See, I've done it. I think God used that for me in a big way. 5 years ago when I was drunk, a little over five and a half years ago now. Let me not negate my half a year, right? So 5.5 years ago when I'm drunk, I was a slave again because I was not spiritually fit and I wasn't standing firm in who I was. And so it was for freedom that he set you free, but it shows you right there, you can get right back, put the bondage back on you, right? I think it's one of the worst things we see is coming here and like get well and you not stay well. You really want to go through this again? Boy, I can't wait to go through the farm again. How many times you heard that one? I'm not doing that ever again, right? Or show back up and, you know, pick up that one, that desire chip. You talk about a hurtful place, man. I mean, I was thankful for it, but you, oh my gosh. The shame, guilt, and remorse like to choke the life out of you, right? So you got to get well and stay well. But if you're free, you should be free. But somebody's got to tell you you're free, and I'm telling you tonight you're free. You won't be if you don't understand your identity. See, that's where I was when let's talk about my years, because many of you, are a lot like what I was. You're saved. You're destined for heaven. You're currently okay because you're like inside these programs, but you have not really changed the way you thought about this yet. Your thinking hasn't changed to the point your identity has changed. You know when my identity changed? They'd still come knock on my door coming home from prison. You guys know who you are. And they would look at me and they knew it was different. I wasn't a place to come no more. I was somebody different. I was new. I wasn't changed. I didn't clean me up. I was new. And you will be too. And you guys are going to have to do that. If you're ever going to live in victory. Now, you don't have to. You can live this struggly way for the rest of your life, you know, and say, you know, you girls, 77.4 years, and you guys, 72.3 years, till you go home to be with the Lord. Just struggle away. That wasn't enough for me. Guys like us, that I had to live in purpose and victory and success. Doesn't mean that life's always great and it's always sunshine and rainbows, by the way. That's not what I'm saying. But I do live in victory, even when things are bad. I'm good, right? Even when things are bad, I'm at peace. That's what I mean by victory. I had to have that because I just know how I do when I don't feel well. How do you like it when you feel bad? Right? Today, I'm able to handle it. When I look like some of you look, I'm not able to handle it. Right? And so that's why it was important for me to learn about this freedom. That 8 years like to killed me, by the way. It did. That 8 years almost took me out. That was the 8 years when I turned 30 and I said, I'll never be 35. And everybody knows I meant it. I lived like I would never be 35. When I hit that jail cell the last time and I opened a Bible, I said, that's it. I'm done. I said, it's me and you or nothing, right? You guys know the story? And so if you're going to be free, some things got to change. Ooh, it's somber in here. Nobody likes change, do they? Therefore, give me the next scripture. Therefore, if the Son makes you free, you shall be free indeed. See, some of that free indeed stuff is not, I don't think a lot of what we call freedom is even freedom, by the way. I think there's a real compromise in recovery now, what we call it. Listen, I'm thankful you're not using today, but if you're not free, I'm really worried about you. I mean it. I'm glad you're abstinent today. But like many people, you know, I made the joke earlier on as we're opening up. I said, you know, people come back and say, oh, I've relapsed. And I'm going, no, you didn't. You just took a break. Abstinence is not equal with freedom. There's a place where you and the Father get so, something just happens and you feel it lift off of it. For the first time in your life, you'll go, you can really breathe. Something changes. and it's free indeed. There's that free indeed is something different. Do you understand me? That free indeed is not, I didn't take a break for a while. That free indeed is I'm good. That free indeed is I'm not shooting heroin today, and I'm not thinking about shooting heroin today. I just don't shoot heroin today. That it's gone. You understand? Our book talks about that too. It says the problem has been removed, right? It talks about that. So long as you stay in fit spiritual conditioning, it says, right? The problem is, I think, so all of us, we want to say we want to live a spiritual life, but we want to do some other stuff. We want to kind of risk it, compromise. I preached a while back, right? What are you compromising? What is it you're okay with? I'm doing this or I'm doing that, right? And you risk it. You compromise where you are. And you guys well know, you give into temptation one area, your mother areas open up. It's like a Pandora's box or something. It's just bad news. And so the difference in you being free is you deciding, do you want what your flesh wants? Lust of flesh, lust of eyes, pride of life. Oh, she looks so good. We're going to move in together and go to meetings and call our sponsor. You know good and well. No, but you know good and well, if you prayed about it, God didn't say, yes, you and her should move in together. Right? Thus saith the Lord, move in with the girl, right? He didn't. And you know why I know he didn't? Because you didn't even consult your wise men. You didn't go to your godly people in your life and say, hey, should we do this? And they said, yeah, you should do it. You know they didn't, right? But I love her, Rocky, right? But I love him. And it's not just that. This phones and pornography, oh, it will wreck you. Yeah. It'll have you so twisted, not three ways to Sunday, you don't even know what happened. Right? Gambling. I'm not telling you guys not to do stuff, by the way. Do whatever you want, right? You do what you will. I'm giving you the information. I'm not trying to put a bunch of rules on you or make you feel bad. Because I did all my own stuff. At the end of it, I finally found out I don't want to do that stuff no more because I don't like what life I end up with. And I can't not end up with that life no matter what when I do that stuff. It just is. And so I'm asking you, how free do you want to be? Give me the next one. I love this. John 8:32 says, and you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Some of y'all need to know some truth, right? The problem with this is that, and it was taught to me, you can't just pull those scriptures out like that, and I'll get to it in a second, but there is some reality to this. What truth do you know? Do you know that there's a God? Yeah. Do you know that a son Jesus died for you and you're forgiven? Yeah. Those are some truths. You better get real, right? Just before this, though, if you read it, Jesus is talking. See, because everybody can quote this one. Almost everybody in here could have said that. You'll know truth. Truth sets you free. Right? We talk about that all the time. Jesus is talking and says this. And just before this, Jesus said, continue in my word. Then you're my disciples indeed. And then you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. How are you going to continue in his word if you won't even read it? You'll watch porn for 40 minutes and won't pick a Bible up. On Facebook for 3 hours if you looked at your scroll counter today. And won't, or TikTok or Snapchat or Instagram, whichever one you want to call it. And won't pick a Bible up, which is the word of God, which feeds your spirit. How are you going to continue in his word and you don't know it? Pretty simple to live it out. He said, love God with all your heart, all your soul, all your mind, all your strength, and love your neighbor as you love yourself. He said, on those two hang everything. But how are you going to do those two when you do everything contrary to that? How are you going to continue in his word? to truly know the truth so the truth can set you free. I'm not here to beat you guys up tonight. I'm here to really challenge you. I'm looking at them like, oh, it's quiet, man. So I want to tell one of them good jokes, like, I love her, you know, whatever. There is a place of freedom that's like nothing else. I wouldn't trade it. I would not trade it. Are you a slave to sin? What are you a slave to? Are you a slave to your phone? Facebook? Snapchat? You're under 22 or 25, it's Snapchat or Insta, right? All them young people, all Facebook, only us old people on Facebook now. I got a profile, but I don't use it, I don't know. What are you a slave to? Listen, there is not a choice. You're either connected to him or you're connected to it, whatever it is. There's not an option. If you don't make a choice for him, there's the decision and the choice for him, the decision's already made for you. Do you not know that? If you don't make a decision for God every single morning, see, every morning I get up like, woohoo, we did it again. And my wife and I said about 5 years ago, we had to finally tell ourselves there's a lot of bad days coming. Said we're going to have a good day no matter what happens. It's about the next thing that comes into my mind. I make a decision. I'm walking with God every day. And if I don't make that decision, the decision is made for me. You don't think so? Try it. Because you'll show back up. There's too many things in the world and in your mind and in your flesh that you'll just be attracted to and think about and want to do that just will overwhelm you. It's not like it's hard stuff. But it is something you got to make a decision and do. And that's the problem with us anymore. There's too many of us that are, we talk and don't do. We say a lot of stuff. For about a year now, I've been preaching that same message. It's high time we get past talking. Oh, I'm going to do it, Rock. I'm going to do it. You see this time. All I say is, we'll see, right? I'm with you. I'm your biggest fan. I'm your biggest cheerleader. I'm fanning your flame. I'm also watching you. Because I've heard a lot of empty words. And that's not a bad thing. I had empty words for a lot of years too. I also had a bad life. I didn't know who I was. I didn't know my identity. I didn't know I was free. I didn't know Jesus had set me free for freedom. See, this whole freedom thing's a whole nother place. It's great to be in recovery. It's a whole nother thing to be free. Right? Recovery, like you, I got to go to a meeting. I got to work the steps. I got to call my sponsor. Well, I do all those things, but I ain't got to do nothing. I'm free. Now, I do have some responsibilities in my life, and by doing those things, I keep my freedom. But I don't have to work to achieve my sobriety today. God's already settled that. I just do those things so I stay connected to God because I've not found a better way to do it. I can't just go to church. I got to be around you guys and do all this stuff. Something about me. See, when he gave me sobriety, I got to go give it away. If I don't give you sobriety today, I don't keep mine. Right? It just works that way for me. But this free in Jesus is a whole nother great place. It's better than just sobriety. It's better than just being in recovery. Because it's your life. Right? And it's great to not have to work at it anymore. Do you remember having to work at it? I got to go to a meeting. I got to work my fourth step. Knowing you lying, you ain't wrote your fourth step, right? Three times I did my fourth step, wrote it in code and everything, man. Scared to death somebody's going to see it. It's for freedom. Somebody say freedom. Give me the next one. Ooh, that's not it. Just take that off her. I'll read it to you. It says, now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. God is Spirit, where the Lord is, there, right? And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. I can't not be where he's at. You know why? He lives inside of me. And if you believe Jesus died for you, he lives inside of you. I know you don't feel it. I've heard that. I don't feel it. It's not a feeling issue. It's a fact. It's about you learning to yield and get out of your own way. And the Spirit will start running the show. You read the Word of God, stay spiritually fit, help other people, do all those, right? The Spirit will start living through you. And you'll see the difference. You know why? You'll do things you couldn't do. No, that's when you know it. Like, I do all kind of things I would never do. They told a story about me Saturday when I was about to give my lead, about wrecked me. I cried puppy dog tears. Like, I don't even remember I did that, but when he told the story, I knew right away. I'm like, I'm not capable of that. I'm a really selfish person. By nature, I steal all your stuff, not give nothing. Right? You guys know what I mean? Like, I'm just a selfish. I'm not a giving person. Right? And so to know that I do things that I usually couldn't do, I know that's not me, right? How many of you guys see yourself already doing things you know is not you? Like God has showed up. Put your hands up, right? It's different, isn't it? It's a really cool place to be. My concern is this. If I don't get you to this freedom place, it's biblical. Let me just tell it to you this way. In the beginning, God's people were trapped in Egypt. He sent Moses to come free them, right? And he comes and gets them. He finally gets them out of there, a long story, bunch of plagues and whatever, but right, so he finally gets them out of there. They're headed to a place which is called the Promised Land. Their freedom, if you will, the Promised Land, right? They never got there. They roamed around in this thing, this journey that was only 11 days, which I think is what we should be able to do this in, 11 days. We never do, but 11, right? So 11 days, 11-day journey, 40 years. The whole time, and if you read the story, since they didn't get to their freedom, what do you think they did? I want to go back to Egypt. I just want to eat some onions and flesh pots. Talk about at least we had meat back there. All these, you'll want to go back to your bondage if you don't get into your freedom. I promise you. It also feels good. I remember what that feels like. You think a half a glass of whiskey tonight don't sound like a feel good to me? Or a big crack rock or a good shot of heroin? Or about two of those green 80s we used to have on your shirt, right? That stuff feels good. I don't forget that. I'm not selling my life out for it, but I remember that. And if I hadn't got into this place of freedom, victory, you think I'm going to keep? Well, I love to struggle. Anybody else love to struggle? Well, I love this struggle. Nobody loves the struggle. You don't even like to get through nothing, much less struggle. Now, it's my struggles, the getting through things that's made me who I am, which I'm very thankful for. But nobody likes to struggle. That's why I had to get into victory. And that's in freedom. It's just, let's say it this way. Recovery's great. Thankful for it. Freedom's supernatural. Right? It's like you, recovery, freedom, right? And freedom really takes the pressure off. Now, you'll still live in recovery if you're in freedom, but you could be in recovery and not be free. Ooh. You can tweet that, right? You got to get to this place of freedom and victory. It's not something I'm selling you guys. Aaron rides around with me a lot anymore, one of my closest friends. ask him how silly it is sometimes. I'm telling you, we laugh about it. He's like, again? Again? I'm like, it's every day. My whole life is silly, supernatural, blessed, because I live in victory. Now, I also have a lot of struggles. I have hard times. I share them with him too. So it's not like it's all peaches and sunshine and rainbows again. Let me not tell you a story like this. Oh, it's so great over here. You'll have your hard times, but it's not the same thing. And I know us. If I'm not here and I get to feeling real bad over here, when I'm here and not there, and you hear that one you love so much, is the girl you said you love so much slept with your brother, and you found out it's true, I don't think you make it. Right? When you're struggling terribly in your marriage and don't look like it's going to make it, I don't think you make it. See, I have faith today to see past those times because I'm here. I have strength today to see past those times because I'm here. I don't know that we have the fortitude and strength to get through those hard times without being here. I don't know how long it takes to get here. It's different for all of us. I believe this way. It can happen now or happen later. That's up to you. That's the difference in a spiritual experience and a spiritual waking. You can believe now or believe later. That's up to you, right? Spiritual experiences are quick all of a sudden. You can believe right now everything that I'm telling you and be free right now tonight. Or you can keep coming back to church and go to church on Sunday and go to some meetings and grow a little bit and read your Bible a little bit and end up at the same place 5 years from now or 10, as I've heard the stories. Or you can just believe it all now and be free. But it'll require you. There's a responsibility on your life to walk with him, to be with him, to love others, to give, which is all I do. The people I know that really love God, you can't help but not give. It's all I know. It'll require you to stay spiritually fit. It'll require you to stay close with him. It'll require you to not do those other things. That's the biggest hurdle right now, those other things. It's the things that are keeping you oppressed. It's the things that you think's comfortable and that feel good. No different than we talk about. Nothing tastes so good as fit feels. I love to eat. I love me a big bowl of ice cream. I love that extra plate of food. It's real hard to be in this kind of shape at 50 years old. I work hard, right? To be in this little bit of shape at 50, and much less the people who really get in shape and have abs and all that, right? It's kind of the same idea. This is way better than whatever comfort thing you're living in and allowing in your life. You're compromising, and it's not going to let you get to where you said you want to go. There's many of you said, I'm going here. And I'm telling you, you're doing something that's going to hinder you from getting there. But I'm telling you tonight, you're free. I mean free. If you believe Jesus died for you, you already are. How many of you know that? Okay, I'm going to go ahead and beat up on you. Then why aren't you living like it? That's not a put down. That's a challenge. Some of you are, by the way. Don't let me say all of you. Some of you are. The ones of you who I said that to and know you're really not, though, I mean, that's a challenge for you. Because I knew I was saved when I was saved, but I wasn't free. Have you changed the way you thought about it? Have you gotten the word of God and understood who he is and who you are? Are you praying? Are you loving other people? Are you loving God? Are you giving? Are you doing what you want to do? That's the biggest problem, isn't it? See, we all know right and wrong, don't we? That ain't even the problem. The problem is what I want to do. It just always is. I'm selfish and I like what I like and I want what I want. You too? Been my experience. And so I had to put me off. Once you do it for a little while, it gets really good and easy. It's not as bad as it was like in the beginning. It's like, oh God, I can't do anything. Life's over. I had to be a spiritual robot. Life was going to be fuddy-duddy, right? God said he gave us richly all things to enjoy. There's a time and place for it. But how you living? I'm asking you tonight, are you free? If you're not, I've told you your first step is to make sure you know who God is and that Jesus forgives you. That's your way back to God. He's your connecting piece, man. If you've not received your forgiveness from Jesus, you and God are going to have a talk. I don't like what it looks like. I knew there was a barrier between us, didn't you? If you don't know that tonight, you do now. Remember again, if you're thinking another direction or way and see God in a different view, I'm not proselytizing. I'm not telling you got to believe like I believe. I know what I know. If you've not had the experience that I've told you about, you might consider it. I don't know anybody told me they were seeking God in another direction and said they had this. I've never met them. I've talked to everybody about every other different version of God they want to seek, and not one of them's ever told me they have this. And so my question to you is, well, if you don't have this, what are you doing? I don't want to have to pray five times a day and hope I do 51% good versus 49% bad or whatever, because I don't think I could outrun my life. I could live from now to 90 and not outrun the bad things that I did, right? And so everybody I've ever talked to say they're seeking God. I've never had one of them say they have this. Not one. I'm talking about free, supernatural. And if you don't have that, I'm telling you what I know. God's real. Jesus died for me. It gave me forgiveness and reconnected me to God and put the Spirit of God inside me to live. That's the truth. Do you get it? How many of you want to be free? How many of you guys received that tonight? Tonight was really a challenge for most of you. Hang tight, let me pray before we leave here. It was a challenge for most of you because I think most of you are saved. Not all of you, but most of you are. So it's a challenge for you to see how free you want to be. Amen? Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we come back to you this evening. We give you thanks and praise, Lord God, as we, this thing we call the movement, we're just a group of people that all declared we wanted more from life, knowing that you, God, are the way. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for sending your son Jesus to die for us, to give us all freedom. Thank you, Lord, for that, to give us forgiveness of our sins, to reconnect us with you, God. We denounce alcohol and drugs from our life that no longer are the ways of the world good enough. But tonight we choose you and your way and your will for our lives, Heavenly Father. We just thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray, and we all said,
amen.
See you guys next Monday.